In the previous example, we created the object of the model, that is a customer object, from the controller class, and we flourished it with some hard-coded data, and then that object was passed to the view and we displayed the object on the view. Now what we'll do is, in this example, we'll create an input screen. So basically we'll create two or three text boxes, you know, from where we can take the customer ID, we can take the customer code and amount, and whatever we type in those text boxes, we will create an object of the model, and then that model will pass it to a view to display it. So basically what we'll do is we'll create an input screen which will take the customer data. There will be a submit button. When we click on the submit button, the customer object will be created, and then that object will be displayed on a view. So in this example, what we'll do is we'll create two screens. One is an input screen, you know, where the user can go and fill the customer ID, customer code, amount, and there will be a submit button. And there will be a second screen, the display screen, you know, where the user will go and display whatever data has been entered into this text box. Okay. Now, we'll have two actions. The first action is the fill customer. So anybody who hits to our MVC project by the action fill customer, it will go and invoke this input screen. The user will go and fill the data into these text boxes and hit the submit button. And when he hits the submit button, one more action will pop up, that is action 2, you know, where the action 2, that is the display customer. And the display customer will go and invoke the display screen. So we'll have two input screens, that is two views. We'll have two actions. So basically in the controller, we'll be having two actions which will go and invoke the appropriate screens. So let's go and try to create these two input screens, and let's try to define the action, and let's see how this whole demo comes up. So here's our customer class we have with all the necessary properties, that is ID, customer code and amount. So first step, let's go ahead and add an action fill customer. So let me go ahead and add first a controller here, and let's name this controller as customer controller. So there's our customer controller class. So let's go ahead and add a simple action here called as fill customer. Okay. So in this action, we will invoke the input page. So let me just say return view. Okay. So we have added a simple fill customer action here. Now let's right click on the fill customer function and add a view called as fill customer. So currently I don't want to select any master page, anything. It's just a simple fill customer. So here's our view, fillCustomer.aspx, and what we have to do is, in this view, we have to create text boxes, we have to create buttons, and in those button clicks, we should be calling the customer class, creating the object of it, and passing the values from the text boxes to this object. Now, a but obvious thing what every .NET developer will do is that basically he will go to the view toolbox and basically try to drag and drop the components from the view toolbox onto the fill customer.aspx, you know. So that's a way we normally design our UI, you know, but there's a catch here. For example, let's say that I drag and drop a button on the view, which is the MVC view. And if I click on the button click, you will see that it doesn't generate a behind code here, but rather it is writing an inline code. Okay. And if you watch closely the fill customer.aspx in the solution explorer, you can see that there is no associated .aspx.cs. So in other words, we are not able to find fill customer.aspx.cs here. Not having a behind code is a perfect thing from the MVC point of view, because the whole point about MVC is to remove any kind of cluttered code which gets tied up with the UI, and all this cluttered code is shifted to the controller so that, you know, your UI is clean, and the UI does only two things: collecting data and displaying data. That's it, nothing more than that. Now said and done that, the next question you will ask is basically, so is it good if you use the server controls of ASP.NET? Well, the answer is no. Why? Because as a good practice, you know, as I said, that basically the whole point about MVC is that there should not be any kind of logic on the UI. The UI will do only two things: collect data and display data. Now the time you drag and drop a server control, you can see that you can write a lot of logic here, because it gives you a placeholder, so the developers can go and start writing logic here, and the whole point is again defeated. So as a good practice, you know, you should not be using the server controls to design your MVC UI, but rather you should be using your simple HTML controls, and the whole code, the logic of the whole logical code of the UI should go, you know, into the controller. So in other words, as a practice, do not use the server controls of ASP.NET. Why? Because then once you use the server controls, you know, you can start writing the logic in the UI, which is again not a good practice. You will not be able to do unit testing. You'll not be able to reuse the code, etc., etc. So let's go ahead and delete this server control for now. So let's create a simple HTML form here. Form. This form will actually post data, so we'll use the method post. And let's start creating text boxes here. We'll give the action later on. So customer ID. So this is customer ID. So input type equal to text. Name equal to customer ID. And just let's put a BR tag so that it looks good. In the same way, we will create controls, HTML controls for customer code, amount, as well as the input button. So the last one will be the button. So let's start. So this will be customer code. And the last one will be the submit button. So input type equal to submit. Let's see. Value. Click here. Reminds me of the old HTML days, you know, in ASP, where we used to write HTML. So again, let me just put this into double quotes so that. Right. So this is the text, so that's nice. So we have created a simple form here, you know, with HTML. So you can see input type text, customer ID, then input type text, customer code, and for amount. And then we have also defined a button which is of type submit. So this will actually make a post. And we have said that this whole form will make a post here. Okay. We'll talk about the action. So action will just keep empty for now. So we have to fill define action definitely. So this is a form here, and this form will be invoked, you know, when I actually call the fill customer action, because this view is tied up with the fill customer action controller, right? So let me just do a save here. Let me build this. Let's go and run this form, and let's see that at least when we call the fill customer, does this fill customer.aspx display properly. So let's first try to test the first action. So build it. Let me do a control F5 here. So that's the application running, and this error is but obvious. Why? Because we have yet not invoked the action. And if you remember, we have the customer controller, and inside the customer controller we have the fill customer action. So let's go ahead and type customer, and let's call fill customer. So the time we call fill customer, it is now displaying us the HTML page which we have created, the .aspx page. Now the next thing is, you know, when we put data over here, right? After that, we would like that, you know, when I click on this action, click here, it should go and invoke the action display customer. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's close this browser. Let's go back to Visual Studio, and let's define a new action result here. So public action result called as display customer, right? So it's a bit slow. Come. Yeah, that's it. So public action result. Display customer. And so we need to create a view called as display customer here. So let's right click on the action result and add a view here called as display customer. And in this display customer, we would like to go and display the object. Now let's create this as a strongly typed view. Why? Because you know, this view will, we are going to actually pass the customer object to him. So let's create it as a strongly typed view and click. So let's start displaying the values over here in the display customer. So we'll say the customer ID is percentage equal to model dot customer ID, the BR tag, and the same way we'll display customer code and the amount. Okay, so the customer code is model dot customer code. The customer amount is model dot amount, right? You know, let's do something different for the amount here. What we'll do is we'll put a if condition here. We'll say that, you know, if the amount is above 100, we'll say that this is a privileged customer, and if the amount is below 100, we'll say this is a normal customer, so that, you know, our view, the display customer looks more better, or, you know, it will actually look more real. So let me go and put a if condition here. So we'll say if model dot amount is greater than 100, then do something else. People who have worked with old ASPX, you know, they will find if condition just old ASP reminds me of old ASPS, I told you. So if this, you know, and else this, okay, and percentage this. So what I'll say is if it is greater than 100, right? So I'll display here the bracket here. So if greater than 100, then display this is a privileged customer, or else we'll display this is a normal customer. Great. So there's a pretty much neat model over there. This displays the customer ID, the customer code, and if the model amount, you know, if you fill the amount more than 100, he will display as a privileged customer, or he will display it as a normal customer. So let's build this. Now there are two more important things we still need to do. Okay. The first one is, you know, here in the action result, we need to create the object of the customer and fill it with the data which you get from the text box, right? And second is basically in the action of the fill customer, right? We need to define that please call the display customer action. So let's go and first say that whenever the submit button is called, please call the display customer action. Now what will happen with this is basically when you click on the submit button, he will actually try to call the display customer action, and he will actually go and invoke the action result that is display customer. And over here what we'll do is let's go ahead and create the customer class and get all the values from the text box and flourish the object. So the first thing is before we do that, we need to go and import the model. So MVC model is in, okay, MVC input screens control minus, so MVC input screens dot models, and over here we'll go and say create the customer object, customer, and first thing is ID. Now if you remember, right, for the ID we have created a text box called as customer ID. So request dot form. Sometimes we just go back to the old days. So people who have worked again with ASP would remember their old days. Convert dot to integer, right? And in the same way, I will actually go and fill the customer code as well as the amount. So that's the rest of the other two properties. So for that also, I have actually used the request.form customer code, populated a customer code. Same way, I have used the amount text box, populated the amount text box, and this object I am passing it to the view. Okay, the view means my display customer.aspx. Right, so we have defined our action over here saying that call the display customer. The display customer will get called. You will create the object of the customer code and basically take the values from your text boxes, that is customer ID, customer code, and amount. And this object, he will pass it to the view, and the view will display the values. And if the amount is greater than 100, it will display it as a privileged customer, or it will display it as a normal customer. So great. So let's run the program. So let me do a control F5 here, and this will pop up the browser. So let me go here and call the fill customer. So this will pop up my UI, right? So basically the fill customer actually goes and calls up the view that is fill customer.aspx. Now the time I press submit, I will be calling the display customer action. So let me put here 1001, let me put here C001, and let me put more than 100 so that we can check if our conditions are proper. So you can see that basically it has now gone to the display customer.aspx and it is displaying me the customer ID is 1001, the customer code is C001, and it's a privileged customer. If I go back and say 20, then it will tell me that it's a normal customer. So very simple screen we have built. So we have built two screens. One is for the input and the second screen basically displays us the output and two actions over here. One is a fill customer and the other one is a display customer. So very simple example. So that was a very simple sample, where we created a simple screen and then we displayed the customer object on a view that is display customer.aspx. Now, one of the things many developers would now ask me is that how productive is this MVC template? Okay, because it is good that, we can do unit testing, we have achieved SOC, that is separation of concerns. It is reusable, it is well architected, it is decoupled, etc., etc. But if it is not productive, then nobody wants to use it, okay? Or I'll say rather than why to use it. When I say productive, in other words, what I'm saying is basically, if you look at right, I have coded the complete HTML with my own hands. So you can see that I need to basically create the HTML. I need to create, the whole thing. I need to go to the controller. I need to create the object, do the mapping, etc., etc. So when I look back, at my server controls, where I can just drag and drop and complete this. And when I look at this, it is like going back to the good old days and coding everything, So definitely the big question now is productivity. Now, in order to basically maximize productivity in MVC, right, we have something called as the HTML classes or the HTML helper classes. The HTML helper classes, help us to create the HTML tags. So, we have to write less code and we can generate the HTML in a better manner. So in the next video, what we'll do is we'll try to understand that what are the different kinds of HTML helper classes we have in MVC and how those HTML helper classes can help us to maximize productivity, rather than writing this thing from scratch and doing the mapping ourselves. So I hope that you have enjoyed this video, and in the coming up video, we'll look at HTML helper classes and see that how we can maximize productivity by using those classes. Thanks a lot.